in hope of making your money work harder for you, you might fall into investment scams that promises very high returns but end up leaving you with nothing. So in this video, I'm going to share with you the three ways you can spot a potential investment scam. Hi everyone, Jasper here. I help young parents to grow their wealth automatically so that they can spend more quality time with their loved ones. The reason why I'm doing this video is because many of you have been asking me, you have seen some form of online advertisements promoting some kind of investment product, and you're wondering about the legitimacy of this content. Do you know that according to the Scam Alert by the National Crime Prevention Council, it's reported that there are over $36 million of scam? And I would think that this figure is actually much higher because there are a lot of people who actually fall into scam, but they are afraid to tell their friends and families because of the fear of looking bad as though they have committed a silly mistake. And the truth is this, there are a lot of scams out there that's happening, and these scams are introduced through a word of mouth. And your friend who introduced you any investment opportunity might not know better. Now let's define what exactly is an investment scam first. But before that, do help me to hit the thumbs up button below so that more people can see this video. You see, some of the investment scams out there are what we call a Ponzi scheme, and it's quite obvious to recognize one because what happens is that the earlier investors has to bring on board newer investors, and when newer investors come in, this amount of money that they invested actually pays off the earlier investors. So you don't actually invest into a physical product or business. So essentially, the earlier that you are on board, the higher chance you have of making money. And then there are some form of investment opportunities that may not necessarily look like an outright scam because they actually invest into actual physical products and businesses. For instance, they invest into land, right, for development. They invest into rare gems, commodities, wood, and so on and so forth. So if you come across such investment opportunities in Singapore, do take note that we have a governing body called the Monetary Authority of Singapore, which governs all form of financial products that has been offered in Singapore. Under the Securities and Futures Act, it governs the regulation of activities and institutions in the securities and derivatives industry, including leverage, foreign exchange trading of financial benchmarks and of clearing facilities. This provides an additional layer of safeguard and protection for the investors. So if you come across an investment opportunity that doesn't come from a familiar bank or familiar financial institution that you know, you might want to refer to the investor alert list that's created by MAS. So according to this list, there are over 500 firms that could be dealing with financial products that are not regulated by the authorities. So there could be certain instances where a new company just came into Singapore or was just created. They haven't caught the eye of the governing body yet. And if you come across such firms, right, the second way you can spot a potential investment scam is when they actually offer very high unrealistic returns. So now here's the scary part, because a lot of people, we are always driven by greed. We may be enticed by very high returns that are being offered to us, even though it may not be possible at all. So in order to illustrate to you what exactly is a high unrealistic returns, let's take a look at the conventional form of investments. So for instance, if you place your money into the Singapore stock market, buying into the STI ETF, which tracks some of the largest listed companies in Singapore, assuming that you placed it in year 2002 till now, it should have performed an average of 5.44% per annum. And mind you, STI ETF has a total investment value of $1.2 billion, and it falls under the stringent regulation in Singapore. And here you have some of the largest listed companies in Singapore who have robust business model and real physical operations in Singapore and globally, and they are only managing to yield about 5% per annum. So if you come across investment opportunities saying that they can yield you double-digit returns month after month, or promises to double your money in a very short span of time, you might want to really go and find out how exactly can they do that and whether or not is it sustainable. In most cases, these investments are taking too much risk, which means that the likelihood of you losing your capital is really, really high. And a lot of times, all these high returns may not be sustainable and definitely not scalable. But here's the tricky part: we wouldn't know that an investment opportunity is a scam or not until it collapses, because it's really difficult to identify how do they exactly operate, possibly because it may not be transparent to the investors. As an investor, you will want to do your own due diligence, because some of these risks may not be talked about by the investment provider, and you will need to have a good idea of the kind of risk that you are taking on. And to really understand this, you need to look at the third area, which is understanding the investment mechanism. So the fundamental of an investment is to allocate resources so that you can gain a form of income or profit. So as an investor, you'll want to know how is your money being allocated so that you are able to derive at that potential rate of return. The funny thing is this, some investment opportunities may be oversimplified or overcomplicated, and that's when you know that you shouldn't be putting in your money. Let's take a look at an example of one that is oversimplified. So there are some investment schemes that promises a very high rate of return without you having to do anything. There's a real case out there that was recently shut down just a few months ago. And what it does is that they ask you to create a forex trading account that is overseas. And once you put money in, they will actually trade on their own system. And all you need to do, the account allows you to copy the trades that are made by so-called the master trader. Now this form of investment is called copy trade, which is not exactly illegal, but when you open an overseas forex trading account, you do not know whether or not that brokerage is regulated, and you might lose your funds because you do not know where your money is being channeled to. And there have been instances where investors are not able to withdraw their money. So while the idea of not having to do anything but get to see your account grow month after month sounds enticing, you really want to understand the risk that is being associated to this kind of investment schemes. And on the other hand, we have seen investment schemes that are overcomplicated, that require a very high level of expertise in order to manage these investments. For instance, we have things like land banking, rare gems, and so on. All these require an expert to help you to select the right property, you know, select the right product in order to resell it. And along the way, there could be hiccups. For example, regulations, currency laws, because all these are mostly overseas investments. And if you are not an expert in this field, it is difficult for you to really understand the risk that is involved. Now, the question of the day, what do you look out for to determine the legitimacy of an investment? Comment down below so that we can all learn together. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you are looking to invest your money, do remember to do your own due diligence and always understand the risk that is involved. There are a lot of investment opportunities out there that could be a potential scam, and it's always enticing to have very high returns, but it may not be realistic at all. So if you enjoy this video, do help me to hit the thumbs up button below and subscribe to my channel to be updated for more upcoming episodes.